As I was playing earlier today in a live stream, I got asked a bunch of questions about runes and rune uses. Now, runes are going to be your main source of builds. Whenever you have a certain amount of runes or a certain rune, you may want multiples so that you can actually create an amazing build. On top of that, it will also be a great source of income. I'm going to show you guys exactly how to do the rune duplication glitch again, because some people really just couldn't get it and a couple of people had a bunch of questions on it. I'm going to answer all your questions and show you how to do this step by step, including creating your very own rune cranking factory, in which you'll be able to crank out runes left and right, and it's just going to be amazing. I'm Dark Shard of the YouTube Assassin. Let's duplicate some runes. So before we get started, I just want to say that doing glitches is not for everyone. You may have to ask your doctor, because in some cases, performing any glitch may cause butt hurt and incessant need to comment on the channel as to why you don't use glitches and why you're holier than everybody else who does glitches. I don't know why, but if it's not for you, definitely consult with a doctor and turn this video off. For everybody else, I'm going to show you exactly what's going on as far as runes go. One of the first things you're going to want to do is go out into the world, play through the game, and there are two things that are going to happen. There are two armors that you're going to find, basically. One of them is going to be over here. Let's see. The Galaglitch armor. It won't be like this. It'll be this level. It'll be superior. It won't be flawless. I upgraded it to flawless. I went out into the world. I found this armor. And then somehow, as I'm traveling around doing other things, locating other stuff, I came across it again. And again, it was this version, the Superior. And I decided to upgrade it, so that way I have two rune slots rather than the one rune slot. So this was like easy to find. Now, the one at the top is the actual one that like was found. This one is a duplicate. Again, found the duplicate out in the world just by playing the game. Just happened to come across it again, opening a random treasure chest. That's going to happen to you. Okay, it for some reason, it happens to everybody. Now, the other armor that I want to point out is going to be... where is it? The Huntsman armor. Now, as you can see, I have this Huntsman armor, and I also have this Huntsman armor, and I've also got a Huntsman armor that is just superior. When I found the original Huntsman's armor, and this is what you have to do, go out into the world until you find this armor. It's in like the very low level areas of the game. Same with this Galaglitch armor. Found this Huntsman armor, and then I went directly here to the store after acquiring the Huntsman armor again. Spoke to the woman here and looked at her wares. She sells tattoos.
As a friend, I think you should buy this.
So as you go to the tattoo, you'll find that it has front, arms, back, some of them are head, so forth and so on. What I did was I found a Munin, M-U-N-N-I-N, front tattoo. Bought that, went
everything?
Over to the blacksmith.
I must be on my way now. Goodbye.
Once I went to the blacksmith in order to upgrade all my stuff, upon speaking to him, before I went to him, I actually took that tattoo over here to the tattoo shop. You have to make sure you've got the armor shop, the vendor, and the tattoo shop open. When I spoke to the woman at, or the man at the time, it wasn't Tove, it was the other guy. I went into his store. I spoke to him. I wanted to change my tattoos and whatnot. There was no exclamation point for the actual chess piece that I had just gotten.
Anything else?
Instead, when I backed out and had to go,
see you later, Frank.
It gave me a duplicate of the Huntsman Abel. Armor. So that's how I got the second Huntsman armor. Now, in doing that, I don't know how I got the third. I'm pretty sure I just, like, traveled around and I found it, like, just doing whatever. But the main thing is that once I had two of that armor, I decided I was going to upgrade it. In upgrading it, only one was upgraded. Now, the other thing that I want to do here is, before I go any further, once I upgraded the armor, I had to upgrade them both. So here we go. Let's see. Here's the Huntsman armor. I upgraded it like I did this to flawless, and then I upgraded it all the way to mythical. Now, I'm probably going to upgrade the Galaglitch armor as well, all the way to mythical, both of them. You're going to have to use resources. Once you upgrade one, it'll upgrade. The other one will not. You'll have to upgrade that one separately. As you can see, that's why this third Huntsman armor is not upgraded at all. So the reason I did this was so that I've got the diamond shape in there. I plan on doing the diamond shape here as well. So what's going to happen is that we're going to go to the duplicated armor, which is this one right here, and we're going to put in some runes. So why don't we put the Vinland rune? And let's see, I know that the great assassination runes that I have are, yep, here we go. I know that these are actually high in value, so I'll put those in there. And then I'll go to the duplicate of the Galaglitch armor, and I will put the same kind of stones in there. The Great Assassination. That's Great Antidote. Here's Great Assassin. And I just need another Great Assassin rune, because the Great Assassin runes are actually going to be high value. So here we go. Another Great Assassin rune. So now what's going to happen is I'm going to go to my original, actually, yeah, I'm going to go to my original Galaglitch armor, go to the rune there, and what I'm going to do is just really quick pop these out. Then I'm going to go to the original Huntsman armor, and I'm going to really quick pop these out because it actually has it on the thing there. The duplicate armor is where we put it, and the duplicate armor we're going to leave alone. So again, this is my duplicate, and this is my duplicate. This is the original, the actual armor, and this is the actual armor. So now comes the fun part. This is the original armor. This is the duplicate armor. When I touch this armor, when I equip it, you're going to see this populate with runes. So here we go. There, it's equipped. And on the original, you see the runes. So now you're going to go to those runes. You're going to pop these out real quick, because these have now been duplicated. And now comes the other fun part. From here, I'm going to go to here. It's going to duplicate, pop those runes out, pop those runes out. You see what I'm saying? So, okay, I'm wearing this now. Boom. Pop these out. Put this one back on. Boom. Pop these out. And then I'm just going to go back and forth. Now, what's really going to be crazy is that I will be able to actually get a whole army of these runes if I decide to go and get more of the tungsten armor or the tungsten bars to upgrade those two pieces of armor. But as you can see, the duplication is actually working. Hold on, I'll show you with these. Look, all these Vinland runes that I had. Now I had three. I did it three times in a row. There you go. So now we'll switch back here, and we're just going to keep going back and forth. And you could do that as many times as you want. Take all this stuff out. I really wish there was a quicker way to pop those things out. But that's what we're going to do. We're going to do that constantly. Then we're going to go, when you have enough of them.
What have you got for me today?
And you're going to speak to this woman again.
I'm practically
and
giving it away.
You're going to go over to sell, and you're going to be able to sell a bunch of the runes that you don't need. Or you could use all those extra runes for your slots or for multiple pieces of armor rather than just constantly going back and forth. So as long as we keep like four or something, here we go, they're 42 apiece.
Anything you find, bring it to
In fact,
me.
We'll start it down here, that way we keep four. So look how quick I made that money. Now imagine if I did that for like an hour, or I did it for like 15 minutes every hour, every day, played through, did that. It would all of a sudden add up to a ton of money that is available that I could sell off all these things. It's pretty wild. It is really, really wild. Now, it doesn't just work for the armor. It will also work for weapons. If you find a weapon or a duplicate weapon, you can do the same thing. And in doing that, again, you could make builds in which you've got multiple pieces of equipment for multiple things. It works out. It's absolutely amazing. You could just continue this thing. Oh, by the way, when you're done, when you stop and you go and you talk to somebody or whatever, all the runes pop out of the armor that you had them in, so they don't stay, okay? Unless you put them actually in the actual armor, which are these two at the top, that's the only way that they'll stay. Other than that, they'll just keep popping out, and you go about your business. There you go. That's all there is to it. Again, there is a way of doing it with this other armor or with these weapons. If you find the right weapons, you can actually do a lot more, in which you get weapon runes and the weapon diamond runes. You could multiply those and use them on other builds or anything else that you need. So here we go. I've got all these villain runes now. A lot of these runes are really valuable, and you really do want to put them on other things, on other gear for like better builds and whatnot, depending on what you have. Sometimes those people that run the shops don't have what you need. It's really odd. And I'm going to do a rune video at another time where I'm going to show you which runes are pretty good and how to acquire them. All right. So that's all there is to it. That's how we do this rune duplication factory, which is absolutely amazing. And we're just going to keep that going constantly. So anyway, let me know in the comments below, how many different sets of armor do you have? Have you tried anything else like that? Have you duplicated weapon runes? Is runes your main source of income, or do you have another source? I'd love to hear from you. And until the next one, take care. Be good.